It was the most selfish act you have ever witnessed. It was 4 o'clock in the morning at my aunt's house and I couldn't sleep. My uncle was seriously sick and was so weak that he was unable to even stand. He hadn't eaten enough as his stomach was not well and he also had kidney problems. He was so sick that he couldn't control his stools and didn't have the strength to clean himself. My mom and I had gone there to help my aunt as she needed a hand and assistance. My aunt was cleaning the mess he had made in the bathroom and he was standing outside, leaning on the door waiting for her to finish so she can clean him up. Unable to sleep, I was reading a book and heard a loud thud. In a jiffy, I ran to the opposite room and find my uncle slipping down and his head banging on the edge of the door making him unconscious. I grab him and call him out, patting his cheeks and shaking him, but there was no response. I tried splashing water on his face and it seemed no good. My aunt is wailing and asking me to do something as I was the only one who could help. Both my mom and aunt are old and are in no physical state to do anything. I quickly call an ambulance as I knew something was wrong and meanwhile tried checking for signs of breathing. As I have no prior experience with such things, I call my cousin who lives in another town asking for his help. He asked me to look at my uncle's stomach for signs of breathing. I checked for a heartbeat and couldn't hear anything but my own heart pounding in stress and fear. I look for a pulse and have no idea if he is alive or unalive. I take the scooter and drive looking for a doctor or a hospital. It was too early for any clinic to be open and I had to do something. I frantically drive to a hospital I know will be open at this hour and manage to get there within minutes. Banging on the door, there was a compounder who listened to the situation and called the doctor on duty who was sleeping in a room. The doctor comes out casually and I explain the situation to him and ask him to come with me. The first thing he does is ask me to pay him $2,000 if my uncle is unalived. His point was, if my uncle was already unalived then he wouldn't get any money for paying the visit and he can't be demanding money later at a moment when everyone is grieving. I agree to everything as I had hopes of saving my uncle who I thought was unconscious. The doctor now says that he needs a car to come as it was drizzling. I was baffled at such a lethargic attitude.